Good morning, children. Hope you are practicing nicely your study matter. This is the second class of your first chapter. In this part, we are going to name the compounds. How to name the compounds? You have altogether 5 rules to name the compounds. First method, when the compound is made up of one metal and one non-metal, then the compound is named by naming with the metal, and for the non-metal IDE is added to name the compound. Here the example is given: calcium plus sulfur. Calcium is the metal, sulfur is the non-metal. Calcium sulfide will be the name. Second method, when the compound is formed by two non-metals, we take the prefix di, tri, tetra, penta for the second non-metal. Like CO2, carbon dioxide, then PCl3, phosphorus trichloride, CCl4, that is carbon tetrachloride, PCl5, that is phosphorus pentachloride. In the third method, when the compound is made up of two elements and oxygen is present there, then the compound will be named by if the oxygen number is less than 2, then it is hypo. KClO, potassium hypochlorite. If the suffix ite is used there in the number of oxygen atom is 2, KClO2 is potassium chloride. The suffix ate is used there if the number of oxygen atom is 3, KClO3 potassium chlorate. The prefix par is used there if the oxygen atom number is more than 3, KClO4 potassium perchlorate. For naming the acids there, if it is binary acid, binary acids means if it is made up of only two elements, then for hydrogen it is hydro what is used, and then for the second element IC is used there. HCl is hydrochloric acid, HBr is hydrobromic acid. Now, naming another acid there, if the acid is containing the radicals of polyatomic group there, then the prefix hydro is not used. If it is HNO3, then the second element is nitrogen, then after nitro, nitric acid is used. Trivial names there, are certain compounds there which is not following these rules. B they do not follow this rule like ammonia, NH3. Like the same there we take water, H2O. Students, please you practice all these naming the compounds there. And you have the exercise questions. Please complete the naming of the compounds. In the next class, we are going to discuss about the reaction and the molecular mass of the certain compounds with the different numericals.